Hello students, today we will be discussing about the JEE mains paper that was conducted in 2017. So here onwards we will be discussing all the 30 questions one by one, the concepts and the tricks to solve the questions of JEE 2017 mains physics paper. Okay. Now let us move to another question, question number 2. Now the question is, the body is thrown vertically upward. Which one of the following graphs correctly represent the velocity versus time? First of all, let me tell you, this is an easy question. This is a very easy question, generally asked in board exams. So the question is very easy this time. Now suppose I will solve here. Suppose I have a surface, the ground, and the object is here. I am throwing it vertically up. When you throw it vertically up, it will go up to a certain height, and then its velocity becomes zero. I have thrown with certain velocity, say any velocity, initial velocity u, which is not given in the question, so you can take u. Here the velocity will be zero. Finally, it will come down following the same path, and when it hits the ground again at the same point, the velocity will be again u. So whatever the velocity with which it is thrown, if it is u, then it will come back to the same point with the same velocity u, but this time the direction is opposite. Initially the direction is up, and finally when it turns back and hits the ground again, it will be like this. So in these two cases, firstly the velocity is positive, and the second, when it hits the ground, the velocity is negative. All the equations we are using, kinematical equations, there the velocity s, v, u, a, these are all vector quantities. So that we have to take into consideration. I can solve this in with the help of equations or without the help of equations also. Let us solve with the help of equation first, then we will explain without equation can we solve this question. Now we have to find the plot the graph of velocity versus time. The velocity versus time, the velocity is taken in y direction and time in x axis. So initially you have, because time t equals to 0 starts from here, time t equals to 0 starts from here. It goes up and come back with the, it follows the same path, but to distinguish, I draw another path, so it will hit here with the same velocity u. So this is the case when time t equals to some time t, after which it hits the ground. So you have to plot the graph from t equals to 0 to t equals to t. Okay. Suppose that this is the t, or this is the t, this is the t, some t value here. Suppose that t equals to t here, here also suppose that t equals to t here, and that t equals to t here, t equals to t here. This is the 0, it is 0 here, here 0, here it is 0, it is 0. Right? Now, if I use the equation to find the final velocity, I know that the velocity v equals to u plus at. Vt graph, so v is u plus at. This is general equation for motion under gravity. I will write the final velocity v equals to initial velocity is u. Acceleration due to gravity is downward. So a equals to minus of g. Any vector acting downward is negative. So this is minus g times t. If I write it in this format, in the format y equals to mx plus c format, then how it will look like? Let us see here. Now, the equation I got was v equals to u minus gt. Okay, this was the equation I got. Now, if I write the equation in the general format, that y equals to mx plus c format, this is the equation of straight line. Now, v I can write as minus g into t plus u. If I compare this, so if I compare, then this is my y, this value is my m, this value t is my x, and this is my c. So it has a positive y-intercept, and that is at u. So initially, if you put t equals to 0 over here, then at time t equals to 0, the velocity is maximum, and that is positive. So you have to draw at the positive side. Otherwise, you can see that the slope is negative. The slope is negative. Okay, the slope is negative. It is of the form y equals to minus mx plus c. This type of, and the graph of this equation is, if I write y equals to mx plus c, then this is the graph. This is the graph for y equals to mx plus c. If I have a graph like a minus mx plus c, then it will be something like that. This is a graph for y equals to minus mx plus c. Now, our is of this type, so the graph should be something like this. Graph should start from some velocity u, and then it should continue like that. So therefore, with a negative slope, we have this graph, the equation. If you see these options, then the option 3 is the correct option. Okay. Now, so this is how you got the graph. But then, let me explain to you in some another way. See, this is the question. Initially, the velocity is positive. Suppose I throw it certain velocity, say 10 meter per second. So time t equals to 0, the velocity is 10 and it's positive. So the graph should be starting from somewhere here. Correct? Suppose that this is 10. This is also possible. This is also possible. So I'll start from here. So these three options are possible. Then what happens after that? As the time passes, the body goes off. As the body goes off, and finally at the highest point, the velocity becomes 0. So that means, after what time the velocity becomes 0? Because we know that when you throw an object vertically upward, after time t equals to u by g, it is at the highest point. So after time u by g, it will have 0 velocity. That means this point is time u by g. This is the point where the velocity will become 0. So, and the velocity is decreasing. The velocity, because from 0 to u by g, the velocity is decreasing. So therefore, you can see it is from, suppose 10, it is coming down to 0. And what about the acceleration? Because the slope of this graph is the acceleration, because the change in velocity over time. And the acceleration is a constant acceleration, because motion under gravity, that is acceleration is minus g. Okay, acceleration is acting downwards, so it is minus g. You can see this is a negative, the slope is negative here. You can see this is a negative slope, greater than 90, theta is greater than 90, so it is a negative slope. And that whether the body goes up or the body comes down from highest point to the ground, the g is always negative. The slope has to be constant, because free fall conditions, the g acceleration due to gravity is always negative and constant. So therefore, the slope has to be maintained. So this line has to be maintained. You cannot change the line. So this has to be like that. So from 0 to u by g, it is perfectly fine. This is the line. And what happens afterwards? Once the velocity is 0, now it starts moving in the downward direction, in the direction of the acceleration. So again, the velocity will keep on increasing, but it should be negative. And when it hits the ground again, then at that time, the velocity again will become the same from where it starts. Suppose it starts from here, say 10, so here also it will be 10. Okay, so here it is 10, but then it is downward, so it is negative. So this is plus 10, this value will be minus 10. From here to here, whatever time it takes, from here to here also it takes the same time. So if it is u by g from here to the highest point and from highest point to ground also, it will take u by z. So the total time of flight is 2u by z. Anyway, the answer to this question is this, because in this case, the slope is negative and is always constant. Okay, thank you.